हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, साई राम। लेट्स कंटिन्यू विद चैप्टर 5, अंडरस्टैंडिंग एलिमेंट्री शेप्स। दिस इज पार्ट 4 ऑफ द चैप्टर। इन टुडे सेशन वी विल सॉल्व अ फ्यू मोर प्रॉब्लम्स फ्रॉम एक्सरसाइज 5.2 एंड देन वी विल मूव ऑन टू लर्न मोर अबाउट द एंगल्स। सो लेट्स सी व्हाट इज क्वेश्चन नंबर 5 ऑफ एक्सरसाइज 5.2। फाइंड द नंबर ऑफ राइट एंगल्स टर्न थ्रू बाय द आवर हैंड ऑफ अ क्लॉक व्हेन इट गोज फ्रॉम 3 to 6. So we have to see how many right angles are formed if the hour hand of a clock moves from 3 to 6. So we can see that here in this picture we can see if the hour hand moves from 3 to 6, it revolves by 90 degree angle or one right angle. So one right angle is formed here. Now if the hour hand moves from 2 to 8, that means if it is moving from here from 2 to 8, then it is forming a straight line or a straight angle, that means 180 degree angle, or it is moving through two right angles. Okay, now next one is 5 to 11. So we can again see that if the hour hand moves from 5 to 11, then a straight angle is formed, or we can say it revolves by 180 degree or two right angles. D, 10 to 1. So when the hour hand moves from 10 to 1, it forms 90 degree angle or it revolves through one right angle. When next one is 12 to 9. So when the hour hand moves from 12 to 9, then it moves through 270 degree angle or three right angles. We can see here three right angles. It moves through three right angles in moving from 12 to 9. Now question number 6, how many right angles do you make if you start facing south and turn clockwise to west? So similar kind of question, how many right angles do you form? Do you make if you start facing south? That means if you are facing south and if you turn in clockwise direction to west, how many right angles you make? You make one right angle, okay, or one 90 degree angle. The next one is if you are facing north and turn anti-clockwise to east. So here we have if you are facing north and if you are turning through if you are turning to face east anti-clockwise direction, in anti-clockwise direction, then how many angles you are moving through? You are moving through three right angles or 270 degree angle. See, if you are facing west and turn to west in clockwise direction. So if you are facing west and if we turn in clockwise direction to west again, then how many right angles we move through? We make a complete revolution, okay, that means we form a complete angle or four right angles, that means we move through four right angles. Now question number 7, where will the hour hand of a clock stop if it starts from 6 and turns through one right angle? So where will the hour hand of a clock stop if it starts from 6 and turns through one right angle? Here it's given how many right angles it moves and we have to tell where the hour hand reaches. Okay, we can see here in the picture also, if the hour hand starts from 6 o'clock and if it turns through one right angle, where will it stop? It will stop at 9 o'clock. We can see that it reaches 9 o'clock when it moves through one right angle. B, if it starts at 8 and turns through two right angles, two right angles means 180 degree angle, which is a straight line. So where would it reach? So just opposite to 8, 2 is shown here, a straight angle. So the clock will show 2 o'clock. Okay, it will show 2 when it moves through 180 degree angle. Now, from 10, it starts from 10 and turns through 3 right angles. So, our hand, it starts at 10 here and it makes 3 right angles. It turns through 3 right angles. So, where it will reach? It will reach at 7. So, it will show 7 o'clock time. Now, so with that we come to the end of 5.2, exercise 5.2. Now, let's move on to the next topic, that is types of angles. Children, we have learned what are right angles, that means 90 degree angles, what are straight angles, that means 180 degree angles, and what are complete angles, that means 360 degree angles. But all the angles are not of the measure 90 degree, 180 degree or 360 degree. The angles may be less than or more than a right angle. Okay, that means they can measure less than 90 degree or more than 90 degree, or they can be less than 180 degree or a straight angle, or it can be more. Okay, so we have different types of angles based on this. So let's first learn about the acute angle. So an angle which is smaller than a 90 degree angle is called an acute angle. That means an acute angle will measure less than 90 degree. Okay, so it can be 40 degrees, 45 degrees, 60, 75. All these angles are acute angles. We have some examples here: the rooftop, a seesaw, and an open book, which show acute angles. Now, what is an obtuse angle? If an angle is larger than a right angle, but it is less than a straight angle, that means if the measure of an angle is more than 90 degree, but less than 180 degree, then it is called an obtuse angle. Okay, we have two pictures which are showing the obtuse angle. Now, what is a reflex angle? A reflex angle is larger than a straight angle. That means its measure is more than 180 degree. We have different types of angles here. So, you can see a right angle. In the first one, you can see a right angle. This is a right angle. And acute angle, which is less than 90 degree measure. Here, obtuse angle, more than 90 degree, but less than 180 degree. Then we have a straight angle, which you have learned. This is 180 degree angle. And a reflex angle. Here we have a reflex angle, which is more than 180 degree. Okay. So, here straight line will be 180 degree and more than that will be reflex angle. And then we have complete angle, that means complete revolution, which is 360 degree angle. Now, different measures of angles also shown. 45 degree angle means what kind of angle it is? It is an acute angle. And here again we have 45 degree, again one more acute angle. 90 degree angle is a right angle. 23 degree angle is an acute angle. 72 degree also, it is less than 90 degree, so it will be an acute angle. And what will be 120 degree angle? It will be an obtuse angle, more than 90 degree but less than 180 degree. So here we have clocks, hands of the clocks, which show different types of angles. You can see first here it is shown, it is less than 90 degree, so it is an acute angle, and exactly 90 degree means it is a right angle, and obtuse angle greater than 90 and less than 180 degree. And a straight angle exactly 180 degree. Here we have a reflex angle also, which is more than 180 degree. And a complete angle or a complete revolution, which is 360 degree. Now let's solve the problems of exercise 5.3. So what is the first question? Match the following. So in one of the column, different types of one of the columns, different types of angles are given, and in the right side column, the measure of the angles will be given. Okay, so you have to match them. First one is straight angle. So what is a straight angle? Straight angle means 180 degree angle. So it is half of a revolution. So this answer is the right answer for this. Second one, right angle. Right angle means what? It is 1/4 of a revolution. Okay, four right angles make a revolution. So right angle means 1/4 of a revolution. Then third one, acute angle. Acute angle means less than 90 degree. That means less than 1/4 of a revolution. 1/4 of a revolution is 90 degree. So less than 90 degree is an acute angle. And what is obtuse angle? Obtuse angle is between 1/4 and half of a revolution. That means it is more than 90 degree and less than 180 degree. So that is E, option E. And fifth one, reflex angle. What is it? The reflex angle is more than half of a revolution. That is option B. And F option is an extra option given. It does not answer any of them. Now, question number 2. Classify each one of the following angles as right, straight, acute, obtuse or reflex angle. So we have to look at the angles here and tell whether they are right, straight, acute, obtuse or reflex angle. So we can see the first one is less than the measure of first one. The angle here is less than 90 degree. Okay, so it is an acute angle. This one is an acute angle. And here the second one, the measurement of the angle is more than 90 degree, but it is less than 180 degree. So it is an obtuse angle. And the third one shows a right angle. Fourth one is a reflex angle. It is more than 180 degree. It is more than a straight angle. So it is a reflex angle. And here fifth one is a straight line. It is a straight angle or 180 degree angle. This angle is 180 degree angle. And in the sixth figure, we have two angles which we have to tell. And by looking at them, we can say that both these angles are less than right angle, less than 90 degree angles or right angles. So they are acute angles. Children, with this problem, we come to the end of exercise 5.3, and we'll end the session here. We'll learn about more shapes, elementary shapes, in our coming session.